I was never going to be a man's physique.
Didn't have much of an off season.
I like his physique better.
I'm always very energetic.
I will have to put me as one of the greatest.
Mr. Olympia was won by the back.
Did you used to live in the U.S. at one point? Did you move to U.S. at one point?
I did, yeah. So I got my visa. I lived in Boca Raton, Florida. I absolutely loved it. It was amazing. And it's weird because that's all I worked towards for the 7 years in the industry before that. I was like, my goal is to live in America and settle there and stuff. And we were brilliant. We enjoyed it and stuff. But my wife at the time was my fiance. She missed home, and we obviously wanted to settle down and have a family and stuff like that. And we just felt like we had a good year there, but it was time to come home and put our roots somewhere.
What's the biggest difference for you outside of weather, obviously, living in the States and living in the UK?
Yeah, I was very naive because I was thinking everything would just be the same as here, just in America. But the temperature, for one thing, was unbelievable. So I've always dieted in cold weather, which my body's used to. So when we went to that type of heat, the weight was dropping off me. I couldn't even get a pump because I was literally getting flat so quickly and stuff. So and I was sweating and perspiring quite a lot. So I had to put electrolytes in, extra sodium in order to counteract that. And it was like trying to find a gym, trying to find a house, all whilst I was on prep. It was a bit silly, really. But yeah, we got there in the end. But that was a big difference. But coming back here, I know I cook out of the same kitchen. I've trained in the same gym for the last 15 years. So it's what I know. And bodybuilding is about consistency. Even if you're a men's physique or open class, it's just about consistency. And that's what I need, basically, for this prep.
I was talking to an influencer bodybuilder from UK one time, and he moved to US, and he said he couldn't get used to the food in the States because it was so much sodium and everything. Did you notice that?
Yeah, massively. Yeah. So that was one thing. It actually worked in my favor quite a bit, if I'm brutally honest, because there was so much sodium and because there was so much in it. If you put like cereals, even, for instance, I know that's not bodybuilding, but I think Chris Gethin put something up, UK versus America, and the ingredients are just phenomenally more. Like, there's so much more in American food than there is in the UK. But yeah, I did notice that quite a lot, but it did help me keep volume, you know what I was saying, because I was losing it. That was one of the things we noticed was helping.
What kind of advice would you give to upcoming men's physique competitors getting into the industry if they want to succeed in it?
Yeah, if you want to step on stage and you've not stepped on stage, I think the first thing is to go to a show and have a look at what class you want to do, whether it's men's physique, classic physique, 212, open, and see what's winning that class. So look at what your height to weight ratio is and see what's winning it. And then be your own worst critique and look at your physique and compare it to that and think, right. Because for me, I never wanted to be just a number. I wanted to, you either go in to win or you're there for nothing. So for me, it was like, I want to do all the research I can. So if that guy's posing in a certain way and he looks a certain way and he's winning that show, I need to see what I've got to beat that guy and stuff. So I would always not rush and get on stage. That's the first thing first, is do the planning first. If you're looking about getting in the industry and making a career out of it, I think don't be hasty to be on the first sponsor who's going to give you a tub of protein and stuff. Know your self-worth. Try and build your own brand if there's sponsors there who are going to help you along the way, that's fantastic stuff. But just know your self-worth and build it yourself. Like make sure you're documenting your story, which I think is very important. I was never a big fan of social media. I thought it was bad because you're taking your phone into the gym. We weren't allowed phones in the gym and stuff like that. We were always old school, hardcore stuff. But it's a great way of getting yourself out. It makes the world a lot smaller and getting your content out to a wider range of people, which in turn is going to help your business, whichever it is.
Now, a lot of guys, especially amateurs, they want to get their pro card, and let's say they go to shows and they don't place high enough, a lot of them, they question the judges. Sometimes they question on social media. I mean, have you ever been in a situation where you just don't agree with the judging and how do you approach it? Do you talk to them? I mean, because obviously they're not going to change the score. It's not going to happen regardless. So what's this advice, how to deal with that?
It is difficult that because obviously you're not always going to agree with someone's opinion or whatever you bought. They're sitting in that chair for a reason and they're the guys who basically are setting the division up for what it is. So you need to adhere to what what they want. So I wouldn't be a guy who wants feedback constantly, though. That's one thing I wouldn't say. Just be the best version of you, because you can get into your head, and then you're constantly chasing something when it's evolving every time and it's changing every time. And it's all about who's the best on that lineup on the day. So if you're going for a certain look and everyone else is in a completely different look, they're going to go for the best out of the different look. So don't consume yourself too much with that, because that's a very, I don't want to swear, but it mess with the mind kind of thing. So for me, it would just be about being the best version of you, taking on the chin, appreciating what they're saying, and then go again. And be realistic. There's no point doing 7 shows in a year if you're never going to win a show. Why not like take a year out, really make the improvements, and then come back and win one show and make an impact in that one show, instead of just doing the rounds?